Hello class 12, today is the fourth day of the chapter attention. We have already done 3 days with this chapter. We have discussed the definition, the characteristics of attention, and in the last class we have discussed the external state of attention. Today we are going to discuss the subjective or the internal determinants of attention. Now see, internal or subjective, basically it depends on the internal state of mind. You will see when we will discuss further the points: instinct, emotion, temperament, sentiment, habit and interest. You will see that all these are internal condition of our mind, or it is directly related with our mental condition. Okay, so first is instinct. Now instinct means, sometimes we say that it is my guess that this is going to happen, isn't it? But I think that he can come to me today, to meet me today. So these are the assumption or assuming, and this is called the third eye, basically, which insists a person to concentrate on a particular topic. Suppose there's a chance of any problem in a group of people. So the instinct of a person will tell him that escape from the place to avoid problem, or to avoid chaos. So the first internal state of mind which affects attention is instinct. So instinct is a factor which will help or insist one individual to do something, to encourage him or her to do something which he is or she is assuming about. Means there is a high probability of not happening that particular thing. He has guessed that, okay, there will be a problem, so let's escape. But later on it has seen that there was no problem. It can happen. But the third eye, or the instinct, or the feeling that yes, something can happen, that instinct suggests a person to put attention to a particular, that yes, you shift from the place, or you don't do the work what you are going to do, because if you do that work, it will give a bad result. So that third eye and that instinct is always tempting an individual to pay attention. Next is emotion. Now emotion is, suppose in a particular thing, in a particular situation has arisen where a person is handling the situation, but standing beside him, you are thinking that it can be handled in a better way. So emotion always control the attention of a particular person. Means the way he or she is behaving with the other person, you are thinking of that can be handled, or the situation can be handled in a particular way. So emotionally you are becoming attached to the situation, as you are, your mind is emotional and it is catching your attention to something else, or a different way of behaving. The third point is temperament. Now the person with a bad temperament, generally you will see they are always negative in mind. They always seek for darker side of an activity. They will never say you something positive. So the temperament also controls attention. They suppose something has happened, it is having both side, good side and bad side, but the person who is having a bad temper or a bad temperament, you will see the attention is falling only at the side of at the darker side, or the negative part of the activity. They never consider the positive side of the issue, that yes, whatever we are doing in our life, whatever we do, how much it is good and how much it is bad, there is some good and something bad in it. So it depends on the individual, that individual's temperature, on which part he will pay attention to, is the positive side or the negative side. Next point, sentiment. Now, sentiment is a great word of life, isn't it? It controls many things in our life. Suppose a group of people and suddenly you saw a person among them who is very much connected to you, but for a longer period of time you don't have any contact. You have met one of your friend who have, he do not have any contact with you for a longer period of time, but in a meeting you cannot go to him and you cannot talk, but your attention will always fall on that particular person who was very much known to you among all the discussions, among all the people over there, those who are sitting, those who are talking, among them your sentiment, your attention will definitely fall on the person whom you know better, whom you know from a longer period of time. So sentiment is it's just an example that sentiment is a particular part of attention which helps a person to attain a particular thing, because you are sentiment, you are attached with the person with some sentiments. So sentiments controls a huge amount of feeling inside. Next is habit. Habit is also we'll see the person who is having these points you will get in the book in the same way it is written in the book. See, the person who is having a neat clean habit, if they will see some unclean dress or unclean room or unclean balcony, they will feel like that yes, something is not very clear over there. I mean, something must be changed. So the person with the habit of cleanliness or neat and cleanness, they will directly see that whether the room is clean or not, where they are going to sit is clean or not. So it depends on, greatly depends on the habit of a person on what particular topic they will attain. Means they will see the neatliness and cleanliness, or they will see, okay, place is there, let me sit. So it depends on the individual that what you are sitting and where you are sitting and whether it is clean or not. Always they will see that yes, if there is dust, they will tend to clean the dust. If the room is untidy, they will tend to clean the room, like that. So habit is greatly dependent on attention. Rather, attention depends on habit, on what particular topic the person is going to pay attention. The last one is interest. Now, interest and attention, as I have told you earlier, it is highly related, because the person who is having interest on a particular topic will pay attention definitely. And if you pay attention, you will get your interest directly. So these are the more or less 6 points of the internal and subjective or subjective determinants of attention. Next day we will discuss about the educational influence of attention in learning. So the question can come like that how attention influence learning, that we will do or discuss in the next day. Thank you.